In this video, we're continuing on with the Systems of Equations Word Problems Worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Picking up where we left off with number 5, it says the sum of the digits of a certain 2-digit number is 7. Reversing its digits increases the number by 9. What is that number? So the sum of the digits is 7. So let's say that the number we use x as the digit in the tens place and y as the digits in the ones place. That means that the number itself, the value, is 10x plus y. Because if x is in the tens place, we're multiplying that value of that digit by 10 and adding it to the ones place y. Now it says that the sum of those digits is 7. So if we take just that x and add it to the y, that will equal 7. Now on another note, it says reversing its digits increases the total number by 9. So if we switch the digits, that means that now y will be in the tens place and x will be in the ones place. So the new value of that number is 10y plus x. So reversing those digits increases the number by 9. So that means the difference of the new number taking away that old number is 9. So then we have 10y plus x, the value of the new number, minus the old number, or the original number, 10x plus y, that's equal to 9. So let me go ahead and zoom in, because now we have our systems of equations. X plus y is equal to 7, 10 times y plus x, minus the quantity 10x plus y is equal to 9. So let's manipulate this second equation. If we simplify this second equation, we'll have 10y plus x minus 10x minus y equal to 9. So 10y minus y is 9y, x minus 10x is negative 9x, and that is all equal to 9. Now notice that my coefficients and my constant all have a value of 9. So if I divide both sides by 9, or essentially multiply this entire equation by 1/9, which is dividing my left-hand side by 9 and my right-hand side by 9, so I'll go ahead and write those out. So I'm not changing the value of my equation. I'll get that y, since 9 divided by 9 is 1, and 1 times y is y, minus 9 divided by 9 is 1, 1 times x is x, equals 9 divided by 9, or 9 times 1/9, which is 1. So my next step, I'm going to solve this equation y. And in order to do that, I'll just add x to both sides. So now that equation becomes y equal to 1 plus x. So by substitution, I'll substitute in 1 plus x in for y in my other equation. So here I was manipulating this equation. So my other equation in the system is x plus y. So plugging 1 plus x in for y, I'll get that x plus 1 plus x equals 7. Subtracting 1 from both sides and combining my like terms, x and x, I'll get that 2x is equal to 6. And when I divide by 2, I'll get that x is equal to 3. So now that I have x, I'm going to use that value of x and plug it in to solve for y. So I'll have y equal to 1 plus 3, which is 4. So I have that x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 4. But if you remember, my question was what is the number? And that original number had x in the tens place and y in the ones place. So putting x in the tens place, that's 3, and putting y in the ones place, that's 4. So my original number was 34. And if you remember, 10x plus y was my original number value, so if I was to plug x in, that would be 10 times 3, which is 30, plus 4, which is indeed 34. Now moving on to number 6, it says that a boat traveled 210 miles downstream and back. So each trip totaled 210 miles. The downstream trip took 10 hours total, and the trip back took 70 hours. It's asking us for the speed of the boat in still water, so essentially the speed of the boat itself, let's call that variable B, and it also asks for the speed of the current, let's call that variable C. Now remember, speed is distance per time. So if we're traveling miles in a number of hours, our speed is going to be miles per hour, mph. So if the total trip each way is 210 miles, I'll have 210 miles on the trip there and 210 miles on the trip back. The downstream trip took a total of 10 hours, while the trip back took a total of 70 hours. So the trip with 10 hours going downstream, the current is helping us. So I'm going to multiply that 10 by the boat speed, B, plus the current speed, C. And notice when I multiply 10 hours by miles per hour, which what B and C are going to be labeled as, that's going to give me miles, which is 210. And the trip back, that current's working against me. So I'm going to take the boat speed and subtract the current speed. So that speed total times 70 equals 210 miles. So now that I have my system, let's zoom in and I'm going to simplify each of these. Now right away, since that 10 is distributed to both the B and the C in the first equation and 70 is distributed to both B and C in the second equation, I'm going to divide by 10 in the first equation and I'm going to divide by 70 in that second equation, simplifying each of those. So 210 divided by 10 is 21, and that's going to be equal to B plus C, since 10 times B plus C divided by 10 is B plus C. Doing the same with 70, 210 divided by 70 is 3, and that's equal to 70 divided by 70, which is 1, times B minus C, which is B minus C. Now my next step, I'm going to use elimination. And if I add these two equations together, I'll be able to eliminate my C variable, the speed of the current. So I'll have 21 plus 3, which is 24. That's going to be equal to B plus B, which is 2B, plus C plus negative C, which is 0C. 0 times C is 0. So I'll be able to calculate my boat speed by dividing both sides by 2. 24 divided by 2 is 12. So if my boat speed is 12, and that's 12 miles per hour, I'll take 12 and plug it in to solve for C. So I'll plug it into this first equation after I had divided it by 10. So 21 equals 12 plus C, and when I subtract 12 from both sides, 21 minus 12 is equal to 9. So 9 is C. Therefore, my boat speed, I'm going to have 12 miles per hour. And for the current speed, I'm going to have 9 miles per hour. And that's my solution in number 6. Continuing on to number 7, it says the State Fair is a popular field trip destination. This year, the senior class at High School A and the senior class at High School B both planned trips. The senior class at High School A rented 8 vans and 8 buses with a total of 240 students. High School B rented 4 vans and 1 bus with a total of 54 students. Every van had the same number of students, and every bus also had the same number of students. So we're to find the number of students in each van. Let's label that V, and each bus, B. So the number of students in a van is V. So for my first equation for High School A, I'll have 8 times V, since there's 8 vans, 8 times V, 8 times the number of students in that van, plus 8 times B, the number of students in the bus. That's going to equal 240 students total. For High School B, I have 4 vans, so 4 times the number of students in the van, V, plus 1 bus, 1 times B, the number of students in the bus, that's going to equal 54 students, the total number of students. Now I'm going to solve this by using elimination. And in order to do that, I'm going to multiply my first equation by 2. So 2 times 4v is 8v, plus 2 times 1b is 2b, and that's equal to 54 times 2, which is 108. Now if I rewrite that top equation, 8v plus 8b equals 240, I'll be able to subtract these two equations to eliminate my terms with v. 8v minus 8v is 0v, which we know is 0. 8b minus 2b is 6b, and 240 minus 108 equals 132. So now I'll divide both sides by 6 in order to get my variable b all by itself, which b represents the number of students on a bus. 132 divided by 6 equals 22. So there's 22 students on one bus, but now I need to figure out how many are in the van. Well, I'll take that b value of 22 and plug it in to any of my equations. Let's plug it into that original second equation before I had multiplied by 2. So I'll have 4v plus 1b, which is 22, equal to 54. So if I subtract 22 from both sides, I'll get that 4 times v equals 54 minus 22, which is 32. And by dividing by 4, I'll get that v, the number of students in a van, is equal to 8. So for the van, we have 8 students, and for a bus, we have 22 students. That's my solution in number 7. Next, let's go over number 8. It says the senior classes at High School A and High School B planned separate trips to New York City. The senior class at High School A rented one van and 6 buses filled with 372 students. High School B rented and filled 4 vans and 12 buses with 780 students. Each van and bus carried the same number of students. So how many students can a van carry? Let's make that variable V again. And how many students can a bus carry? Let's make that variable B. So our first equation is going to be 1V plus 6B. That will equal the number of students, which is 372. Our second equation will have 4V plus 12B. That's equal to 780. 4 vans, so 4 times the number of students per van, times 12b, 12 times the number of students in the bus, equals 780 students total. Now I'm going to solve this by subtracting by 6b in my first equation. So if I subtract 6b from both sides, I'll get that 1v, or simply v, is equal to 372 minus 6b. Now I'm going to take that value of v and plug it in for v in my second equation. So I'll have 4 times 372 minus 6b plus 12b equal to 780. Distributing that 4, 4 times 372 is 1,488 minus 4 times 6b is 24b. And if I'm adding 12b to that, that's equal to 780. So I'm going to subtract 1,488 from both sides. And in that same step, I'll also combine my negative 24b and 12b. So I'll get that negative 12b, negative 24 plus 12 is negative 12. So negative 12b equals 780 minus 1,488, which is negative 708. So dividing both sides by negative 12 will give me the number of students per bus, B, which is 59. Now, since I'm solving by substitution, I'll easily be able to take that value of B and plug it in to solve for V. So I'll have V equal to 372 minus 6 times 59, which is 372 minus 354, which is equal to 18. So a van can carry 18 students, and a bus will carry 59 students. That is my final solution in this video. Join me in the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 9 through 11. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.